Perhaps every DSLR in the market today allows you to change a setting in your camera called the color profile, and you have an option of changing your camera's color profile to the Adobe RGB or the sRGB color profile. Many people are really confused about what this setting is, and they've heard perhaps that Adobe RGB is a better color profile to use, and most of them are making this change on the field. By the way, can I please request you to subscribe to this channel so that you get all the updates that we send. Also, it's a good idea to hit the bell icon so that you get instant notifications when we have new content. Well, if you actually use your camera and shoot DSLR pictures using the RAW file, you actually don't have to worry about this particular setting in your camera, because this is actually a post-processing technique setting that you're actually setting in your DSLR. Who should set this then? Well, if you are a photographer who uses the JPEG format and you want to shoot pictures which also, or rather the camera also post-processes the pictures in its own setup inside the camera and produces a JPEG file, then you should be worrying about what settings you should have your camera on, Adobe RGB versus sRGB. But let's first understand what is the difference between the two. Well, when we speak of colors, let's consider that Adobe RGB is a color gamut, which means it has some colors inside its purview. And compared to the sRGB color profile or the color profile of the sRGB, the Adobe RGB has a larger allowance of accepting and being able to appreciate colors. It simply means Adobe RGB can understand and exhibit more colors than sRGB can. So let's understand what color profile to use when. Well, if you are actually taking pictures for the web, and if you want to post photographs on a website like, let's say, Flickr or maybe Instagram or Facebook for that matter, you're actually processing pictures for the web. And most browsers in the world actually only understand the sRGB color profile, which unfortunately has a lesser color gamut than the Adobe RGB profile. So then what is the need of the Adobe RGB profile? Yes, if you are actually printing photographs and if you're actually producing a high quality fine art print, it makes sense for you to process your photographs and export them in the Adobe RGB color profile, because now your printer is definitely capable of understanding more colors than your browsers. So if you actually are posting pictures on the web, you should convert your pictures into the sRGB color profile. And if you're actually making pictures for the print, you can actually be converting your raw file into an Adobe RGB color profile. Now let's have a look at my desktop. There is this beautiful photograph. It's an abstract of a scarlet macaw's body, and you can see a lot of colors here. There is yellows, greens, and blues. Now if I'm exporting this photograph for the web, I'm actually pressing Shift Control E on a Windows machine and Shift Command E on a Mac. If I'm doing this, it actually allows me to go ahead and select the color profile in which I'm actually processing this image and saving it as a TIFF or a JPEG. By the way, TIFF is yet another file format. Now I can actually go ahead and change this from sRGB to Adobe RGB color profile. This is where you actually make this change, and in spite of you wanting to post this on the internet, you don't need to have an Adobe RGB color profile there. In fact, it's going to be a problem if you process images and you post them on the web with an Adobe RGB color profile, because browsers cannot understand this color profile. But if you are posting it online, you should convert it into an sRGB profile, and you should actually be exporting images as an Adobe RGB color profile if you want to print only. So that's the major difference between the two color profiles. Do not worry about this in the settings of the camera. By the way, I have an interesting feature to display. I'm right now working on a monitor called the BenQ SW320, and this is one of the monitors which has the capability to display colors which appear on a print, which means it has the capability of displaying Adobe RGB colors to you. What it simply means is when you process images in your laptop and you print an image, it appears definitely completely different from how it appeared on your monitor, because the print is going to have more colors than what the monitor can show you, because the monitor can only show you lesser colors than the Adobe RGB. That's why we invest in a monitor like this, which has the capability to display Adobe RGB colors. And especially on this monitor, I have a hardware control switch. If I actually be
pressing the number one here, I have configured the monitor to actually be showing me the Adobe RGB color profile. So I'm going to press one here and it actually shows the Adobe RGB color profile rendering on the monitor itself. While in my laptop later on, if I see, this would be looking like the sRGB. If I go back to number two, I have configured my monitor to show the sRGB color profile, which is a little dull compared to the saturation and colors of the Adobe RGB color profile. So it's very important for you to understand when should you use Adobe RGB and sRGB. Chances are, if you're just posting it for the web, you don't need to worry about Adobe RGB. But if you are printing, you definitely need to worry about the Adobe RGB color profile. To understand about the color profiles and post-processing and also get into the develop module of Lightroom, I request you to actually check out our course on Lightroom Classic CC, and the link to this course is provided in the description below. And please don't forget to subscribe to this channel, the Toehold TV on YouTube.